Okay, what is the SI unit of the spring constant? Newton per meter, no? So Newton per meter. It is the spring constant. It is the spring constant. Okay, I will explain again here. One rod is fixed with certain inclination 30 degree with the horizontal, and it is fixed to the vertical wall also. Okay, here from the rigid support, one end of the spring, light spring is connected to one out. Connected to the rigid support, and to the other end, a ring having mass 1 kg is fixed, and the ring is passed through this smooth rod. The ring is smooth and rod is also smooth. That's why in between ring and rod there is no friction. Okay, whenever the ring is at A, the spring is vertical and no extension or compression is there in the spring. That's why it is in unstretched condition, whose length is equal to root 3 plus 1 when ring is at A. Okay, now when you release the ring, the weight component, here you see weight mg acts vertically down direction. When you resolve them into components, this component is mg cos 30, this component is mg sin 30. Because of this weight component, mg sin 30 acts on the ring along the rod downwards, the ring starts sliding in this direction. Because whenever the ring is here, as there is no compression or extension of the spring, no spring force is developed. Only weight component acts along the rod. That's why the ring starts motion along the rod in downwards direction. Okay. At the same time, whenever the ring displaces from this place, immediately extension of the spring starts. Whenever extension of the spring starts, immediately spring force develops here. And the spring force component, acts on the ring along the inclined plane upward, along the inclined rod upwards. And normal to inclined plane also some spring constant is there. Okay. Now, whenever the spring gradually, the ring gradually comes down at certain position, the weight component balances the spring force on the ring along the rod, along the incline of the rod upwards. Whenever these two are equal, at that time, up to that, the ring comes down with increasing velocity and velocity becomes maximum at that position whenever the spring force constant along the inclined rod and weight component are equal. After that, here it acquires the maximum velocity. After that, as it acquires the maximum velocity, with that velocity due to inertia of motion, the ring continues their motion away from this equilibrium position. Whenever the ring moves away from this equilibrium position, the spring further extends. Due to that, the spring force component acts on the ring along the rod upwards, becomes greater than the weight component along the incline, along the rod. Okay, due to that, the velocity of the ring gradually decreases, and whenever the ring reaches the point B, the velocity of the ring becomes zero. Whenever velocity becomes zero, at that time, what is the displacement of the ring? They asked it. Okay, what is the spring constant? And moreover, one more is given. Whenever the ring comes to rest, the spring makes an angle 30 degree with the vertical. That is given. Whenever the ring is here, the position of the spring is like this. The spring makes an angle 30 degree with the vertical. That is given. Okay. Now, whenever the ring comes to rest momentarily, at that instant, whenever this angle is 30 degree, at that time, what is the displacement of the ring? What is the normal reaction acts on the ring? And what is the spring constant? They asked. Okay. For that, here we see, if it is 30, as the angle made by the rod with horizontal is also equal to 30 degree, then if you draw a horizontal line, if it is 30, this is equal to 30. As it is horizontal line, and it is vertical, it is 90. 90 plus 30, 120. That's why angle between the original position of the spring and the rod is 120. It is 30 given in the problem. If it is 30 and it is 120, in this triangle, obviously it is 30 degree, no? Now, in this triangle shape, at all three corners, angles are known. So, we can apply the Lamy's theorem, no? According to Lamy's theorem, L by sine of opposite angle sine 120 is equal to L naught by sine of opposite angle sine 30. That is equal to S by sine of opposite angle. As these two are equal, definitely displacement of the ring is equal to L naught. So, displacement of the ring is equal to L naught. L naught is given root 3 plus 1 meter. That's why this is equal to root 3 plus 1 meter. But answer is given, displacement of the ring is not given directly like this. That is given like this. So, you rationalize them with root 3 minus 1. You multiply with them, divide with them. It makes no difference. Then S is equal to this one. Next. Here, what is the displacement of the ring is over. Displacement of the ring we got. Next, in order to find the K value, in order to find the spring constant K or stiffness constant K, definitely we need the extension the spring whenever the ring comes to rest momentarily. So extension the spring we need. So you see, whenever the ring comes to this position, suppose the length of the ring becomes say L. If you know this L, original length is already known, unstretched, in unstretched condition L naught. L minus L naught gives extension the spring whenever the ring comes to rest here now. That's why from the same formula here, from Lamy's theorem, L by sine 120 equal L naught by sine 30. From this formula, L by sine 120 equal L naught by sine 30. L naught is already root 3 plus 1 meter is given. Given. So from this L is equal to L naught means root 3 plus 1 into sine 120 by sine 120 means that can be written as cos 30 by sine 30. Cos 30 means root 3 by 2 by sine 30 means 1 by 2 means into 2. 2 to cancel. Root 3 into root 3 plus 1. This is the L value. Therefore, extension the spring. L is equal to root 3 of root 3 plus 1 minus L naught means root 3 plus 1. When you subtract, then we got extension the spring when the ring comes to rest at B is equal to 2 meter. So now, extension the spring is known. Whenever the ring comes from this position to this position, because of gravity it comes down, at the same time because of spring force work is done on the ring against their motion. That's why due to these two works, net work done is equal to, according to Watkins theorem, as there is no friction here, net work done is equal to change in kinetic energy of the ring. Initial velocity is zero. Whenever the ring comes to rest at B momentarily, that velocity is also zero. That's why initial and final velocities are zero. That's why final and initial kinetic energies are zero. That's why zero. Net work done means work is done by gravity and work is done by spring force also. Work done by gravity means along this length of the rod, the displacement of the ring is F and weight component acts along this direction mg sin theta, that is constant. That's why work done by gravity means only mg sin theta into S. No work is done by this other component mg cos theta. So mg sin theta into S is the work done by gravity and work done by spring whenever the ring comes from this position to this position. Whenever the spring comes to this position, the extension of the spring already we got here, x is equal to 2 meter. That's why work done by the spring on the ring, whenever it comes from this position to this position is equal to, as whenever the ring comes here, the spring force acts on the ring opposite to their motion. That's why negative work is done. So minus half kx. That is equal to 0. From this, if you simplify them, we got k is equal to 5 by 2 into root 3 plus 1 newton per meter. Next, what is the normal reaction they asked? You see, the weight component of the ring acts vertically downwards direction, and so the spring force component acts on the ring in upward direction. Okay, even then, whenever the weight component is greater than the spring force component, then the ring pushes the rod in downwards direction with the resultant force. That is the resultant force. Okay, then the equivalent reaction force acts on the ring in upward direction by the rod. So therefore, normal reaction N is equal to, of course, along this direction, as there is no motion, this plus this is equal to this one, or this minus Fs sin 30 is equal to N, we can write. N is equal to mg cos 30 minus Fs sin 30. It is the normal reaction. When you substitute the values, mg cos 30 minus Fs sin 30, mg, M means mass is 1, G is 10. So 1 into 10, cos 30 means root 3 by 2, minus Fs means Kx, no? Spring force means whenever the ring is here, spring force is equal to Kx. Already extension is known, X is equal to, we got here 2. That's why K into X means, since spring force is equal to K into X, X means 2 meter into sin 30, 1 by 2. So this is normal reaction here. So you substitute K value. Already K value is here now. You substitute K value also. Already we got K value. So you substitute K value also here. K means 5 by 2 into root 3 plus 1. Into X means already 2 meter we got here. 2. Into sin 30 means 1 by 2. 2 cancel. Therefore, from this N is equal to, you see, 2 5s are 5 root 3 minus here. Okay, 5 by 2 is there now. Okay, 10 root 3 by 2 minus 5 root 3 by 2. That means 5 root 3 by 2 minus 5 by 2 you will get. So if you simplify them, then 5 by 2, you see, 10 root 3 by 2 minus 5 root 3 by 2 means you will get 5 root 3 by 2. 5 root 3 by 2. by 2, like this. Okay, minus 5 by 2 plus into 1 means 5 by 2. So 5 by 2 when you take common, then root 3 minus 1 you will get. So 5 by 2 into root 3 minus 1, that much Newton. This is the normal reaction exerted by the rod on the ring. Normal reaction exerted by the rod on the ring. Suppose here friction is there. Suppose here friction is there. That friction force acts on the ring along the rod upwards. That's why plus F, WF. That is negative. Negative work. That's minus F into S we had to write. Minus F into S we had to write. Okay. All of you stop your video sharing. Okay. All of you note this one. Okay, is it over? Shall I erase this part? Shall I erase this part? Baladitya, if you are having work, you leave the class. Baladitya, I may conclude the class at 8 o'clock. Okay, shall I erase this one? Vijay, shall I erase this one? విజయ్ ఎరేజ్ చేయాలా? Next one, can you able to see or not? I think you are unable to see that one. Okay. Here, the block of mass. Okay, I will draw the diagram here, you see. First I will draw the diagram, then I will read. Okay. Okay, you see, all of you see this one. A block of mass m is connected to a spring of spring constant k. The spring constant is k. All of you see the board here. It is a block which is connected by means of a spring to the block of mass m is connected to a spring of spring constant k as shown in the figure. The frame in which the block is placed, this is the frame in which block is placed, the frame in which block is placed. Here, this is the frame. The frame in which block is placed. The frame in which block is placed is given an acceleration. That means this frame is given an acceleration here towards left. Okay, neglect the friction between the block and the frame. Here, between the block and frame, as rollers are there, there is no friction between the block and the frame because of these rollers. That is mentioned. Maximum velocity of the block relative to the frame they asked. So with respect to this frame which is moving with an acceleration, what is the maximum velocity of the block they asked? Maximum velocity of the block they asked. Here you see, initially whenever the block is here, there is no extension or compression in the spring. It is in unstretched condition. Okay, now whenever this frame is moving with an acceleration a towards left, at the same time the pseudo force acts on the pseudo force acts on the block towards right. That is equal to MA pseudo force. So pseudo force MA acts on the block towards right. Because of that, the block starts motion towards right. Whenever the block starts motion towards right with acceleration A, at the same time, whenever the block displaces from this position towards right, immediately the spring starts extends. Whenever the spring starts extends, at that time, of course, the spring force initially less than the pseudo force. That's why the block will accelerate towards right. Due to that, as long as the block displaces towards right, the extension of the spring gradually increases, so that the spring force gradually increases. The spring force in backward direction gradually increases. Whenever the block displaces towards right at certain position, whenever spring force and the pseudo force acts on the block are equal, up to that, the pseudo force greater than spring force. That's why the block accelerates towards right. The block accelerates towards right until the spring force balances the weight. So the block accelerates up to block accelerates until pseudo force balances the weight. Whenever pseudo force balances the weight, at that time the net force acts on the block becomes zero, so that block acquires the maximum velocity. So maximum velocity of the block is called say Vmax. We have to find this maximum velocity of the block. So in order to find the maximum velocity of the block, then we have to make the net force acts on the block become zero. So MA is equal to FS. When FS is equal to MA, that implies FS means K into X. Spring constant K into extension of the spring is equal to X. That is equal to M into A. So in this case, extension of the spring is equal to, whenever the block acquires maximum velocity, at that time, extension of the spring, V max is asked. So extension of the spring, extension X is equal to, from this formula, MA by K, you know, this is equation 1. Extension of the spring is equal to MA by K. Okay, you see, extension is equal to MA by K. Now, as extension is known, initial velocity of the block is zero. Initial velocity is zero. Whenever the block displaces through certain distance, that means X. Whenever the block displaces through distance X, the spring extends by X. That's why whenever the block displaces through a distance X and acquires the position here, like this, then velocity of the block becomes Vmax. We had to find. So here, whenever the block displaces through a distance x, work done by pseudo force we can calculate, work done by spring force we can calculate. As initial velocity is zero, initial kinetic energy is zero, final velocity is Vmax, they ask it. That's why final kinetic energy we have to find. That's why you apply the work energy theorem according to work energy theorem, or we can apply the law of conservation of energy principle also. According to work energy theorem, you see, whenever the block moves in this direction, due to which force block displaces towards right for distance x, due to which force the block displaces towards right, because of pseudo force. This pseudo, whenever this frame, wire frame moves with constant acceleration in this direction, pseudo force also constant. With this constant acceleration, with this constant pseudo force MA, as the block displaces through a distance x, then work done by, of course, net work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. This is general formula. Net work done means here work done by the pseudo force is there. Whenever the block moves in this direction, the spring force acts on the developing the spring acts on the block in opposite direction. That's why by spring force negative work is done, by pseudo force positive work is done. That's why work done by pseudo force plus work done by spring force, that is equal to here final kinetic energy means half m into V max square minus, as the initial velocity of the block is zero, initial kinetic energy is zero. Now you write what is the pseudo force. Work done by pseudo force. Because of pseudo force, as the block displaces through a distance x, work done by pseudo force is MA into x. Okay. Next, whenever the block displaces through a use certain displacement x so that the block is under equilibrium at the time the work done by the spring force is equal to. Whenever the block displaces in a distance x, the spring also extend by a distance equal to x. That's why work done by the spring against the motion of the block. Endukante block it by force ante spring force the opposite direction only. That's why work done by the spring force is negative, which is equal to half kx square. Now already we derived this formula. That is equal to maximum kinetic energy half m v max square. Now from this formula, x is equal to ma by k. Now x is equal to ma by k. You substitute here. Ma into x means ma by k minus k by 2 into x square means ma by k whole square. That is equal to half m v max square. Therefore, half m v max square is equal to ma whole square. That means m square a square by k minus here m square a square by 2k. We can take out. That is equal to here. You take LCM, 2k. Here 2m square a square minus m square a square means we can write m square a square. Now this is equal to half m v max square. Here mm cancel, 2 cancel. Therefore v max is equal to root of this one. Root of this one means a into root m by k. You will get now. So this is the maximum velocity acquired by the block. It is the maximum velocity acquired by the block. Yeah. A into root m by k, that is the maximum speed acquired by the block. So in this way we have to do. In this way we have to do. Yeah. Okay, I think you are understanding the lengthy the difficulty of the problems. That's why every problem almost all takes 15 minutes to calculate. That's why only few problems are only completing in every section, in every class. That's why I am taking the extra class today. Tomorrow I don't want to take. Tomorrow only morning regular class is there. I don't want to take extra class in the evening. Only today I want to take. I wanted to take. Okay. Last second. This one. To think. Okay. Half m v max square is equal to. You take LCM, 2k is LCM. Then, as k is there, you have to multiply with 2. 2 m square a square minus m square a square whole by 2k. That means m square a square by 2k only, no? M square a square by 2k only. Okay, then here m square cancel, 2 cancel. Then v max square is equal to m a square by k. Or v max is equal to root of this one means a into root m by k. A into root m by k. So that is the problem. Next, yeah, one more problem. Shall I erase this part? Shall I erase this one? Okay, next 10th one. When free end of the spring of mass, when free end of spring of mass m is pulling with a velocity v naught. With a velocity v naught, from then kinetic energy of the spring is dash. It's very very important one. Here you see diagram is given like this. it is the spring. One end of the spring is fixed. The mass of the spring is m. Spring constant is not given. The other end of the free end of the spring is pulled towards right with a velocity v naught. One end of the spring is pulled with a velocity v naught. At the instant whenever the velocity of this end is v naught, at that instant the length of the spring is say l naught. The length of the spring is say l naught. So at the instant whenever the length of the spring is l naught, at that time the velocity of the spring is the velocity of the free end of the spring is equal to v naught. Already previously we did, based on this problem we did the based on this concept we did the problem. Here from the end where the velocity of the end is given, from that end at a distance x, what is the velocity of the velocity of that point on the spring? V and v naught velocity both. But of course when two ends are moving with velocities v1 v2 already excited in the video also, it is there, it is uploaded also. One end is fixed, that's why velocity of this end is zero. Whenever the other end is pulled with a velocity v naught, at that time what is the velocity of any point on the ring, any point of the spring at a distance x from this end? In order to find them, as the velocity of every point in the ring varies linearly with the distance, at this point velocity is zero, at this point velocity is v naught. That's why the velocity of the each part, each point on the ring, each point on the spring varies from zero to v naught up to a length l naught. That's why change in velocity from one end to other end is equal to v naught minus zero by a length l naught. Then what is the change in velocity per unit length? Change in velocity per unit length is v naught by l naught. If it is the change in velocity per unit length, then what is the change in what is the velocity of this end? What is the velocity of this point, which is at a distance x from this end? That v is equal to cos mark. That's why, but from this v end at a distance l naught, if the change in velocity is v naught minus zero for this l naught, what is the change in velocity per unit length means v naught minus zero by l? Then what is the velocity of this point of the spring at a distance x means into x? This is the velocity of this end. It is the velocity of this point of the spring. Now at a distance x from the free end, suppose we consider is an element having length dx and mass of the element is say dm. Then what is the kinetic energy of that element? As this element is at a distance x from the free end of the spring, the velocity of this element is equal to this one. Therefore, kinetic energy of that element delta k is equal to kinetic energy of that element is equal to half into mass of the element dm into velocity square. Therefore, kinetic energy of the element, or you say dm, dk. Kinetic energy of the element dk is equal to half into what is the mass of the element? The total mass of the spring is m having length l naught. Then mass per unit length is m by l naught. If mass per unit length is m by l naught, but this much length of the element, what is the mass means into dx? It is the mass of the element into v square means this square. This means v naught by l naught into x whole square. Therefore, this is equal to half m naught by l naught into l naught square into v naught square into x square into dx. This is the kinetic energy of the element considered at a distance x from this free end. So what is the kinetic energy of each and every part of the spring from this end to fixed end? Therefore, total kinetic energy of entire spring is equal to integral dk between the limits x is equal to from free end 0 to fixed end means this length is equal to l naught now. So x is equal to l naught. That is equal to integral 0 to l naught. X is equal to 0 to l naught. Dk means this one. So m naught v naught square by 2 l naught square into x square dx. We are integrating with respect to distance only. Remaining all are constant because it is moving. This free end is moving with constant speed. Constant speed. That's why v naught is constant. M naught is constant. All these are constant. Of course here it is not m naught. M is given. In the problem m is given now. So m you write. Okay, therefore, so you write m v naught square by 2 l naught square outside. M v naught square by 2 l naught square you write outside. Integral x square dx. Limits x equal to 0 to l naught. This is equal to m v naught square by 2 l naught square into integral x square dx means x cube by 3, no? limits 0 to L0. Therefore, this is equal to MV0 square by 2 L0 square into, when you substitute the upper limit, L0 cube by 3, and when you substitute the lower limit, it becomes 0. That's why you'll get like this. So here, L0, it is L0 cube by 3 only, no? Okay, L0 cube by 3. So here, L0 square cube cancel. Okay, it is 2 into 3, 6. Is it correct or not? Here L0 square, here L0, L0 cube is there. L0 cube. L0 cube is there. L0 cube cancel. Therefore, kinetic energy of the entire spring, kinetic energy of spring, when free end moves with a velocity V0 is equal to, K is equal to, MV0 square by 6 you get. That means 1 by 6 MV0 square. This is the kinetic energy of the entire spring. Kinetic energy of the entire spring. Okay. Okay. With this, the extra problems are over. In our material,